Welcome everyone to the fifth round of World Junior Chess Championship. On the top board, we have Pragnananda taking on Evgeny Stembuliak. Pragnananda was in great form and even in this game, he sacrificed an exchange. But it was not enough. Stembuliak played excellent chess and scored the win, taking the sole lead in the tournament with 4.5 out of 5. A check on e8 and Prag stops the clock. What is really nice to see is how Pragnananda, even after losing, analyzes the game with his opponent. On board number 2, we had Aram Jacobian, who got the better of Miguel Ruiz of Spain. Jacobian played a beautiful game from the white side of the Ragozin, breaking with e4 at the right moment. On another board, we had Indian GM Murli Karthikeyan, who played exceedingly well in his game to beat Harshit Raja. Karthikeyan had a minus position out of the opening, but he kept his cool, forced his opponent to make mistakes, and here you can see he's a pawn up with a better structure, and he slowly managed to grind out the win. Indian is back in form after a nice win over Amar Tushin. Look at the position where Indian has his pieces nicely placed in a King's Indian-like attack. He was able to finally win the e4 pawn and later the game. Amay Audi played a nice Benoni sacrifice in this game and his opponent looked really well prepared. This game was really spectacular. It's between Kostashi, who's white, and Wang Shixu. Bishop e3 check was a nice move, clearing the d-file, and now knight into a2. If the knight takes the knight, then d1 is a checkmate, queen into d1. So king c2, knight came back to b4, and white had nothing better than to repeat the moves. On the other end, there is a checkmate, but black is just in time to hold the draw. Moving to the girls section, on board number 1, we had overnight leader Bolbatar Altuntuya against Bibisara Asuibaeva. Bibisara was completely in control. She picked up a pawn on c5 and it looked like she would win the game. However, Altuntuya didn't give her opponent a chance and she held on to a draw. On board number 2, we had two Indians playing, Arpita Mukherjee with the white pieces against Rakshita Ravi. The game ended in a draw. Moving on board number 3, we had Mobina Alina Saab, who created a nice victory with the white pieces against Priyanka Nuttaki, and she moves on to join the leader on 4.5 out of 5. Stavrola Solakidu with the black pieces was under a lot of pressure by Yakuboeva. And here you can see black king is under a lot of threats, but she managed to defend really well and she won the game. After losing to Mrudul Dehankar, the second seed is now back with 4 out of 5. Polina Shuvalova won her game in a marathon encounter. She played nearly 115 moves, a lot of them in the rook end game, and she managed to beat her Russian opponent. As you can see here, she's a pawn up and she has her rook on the 7th rank. Her opponent Ekaterina Diakonova tried hard but in the end had to give up when black king started to enter the position. Polina plays her king to e4 and later on when white was passive with rook to h8, she managed to get her king further in. A nice win for the under 18 world champion. Vantika Agarwal was playing against R. Vaishali. Here you can see a nice bird's eye view of the playing hall. And we see Pragnananda, who's just lost his game, come and check his sister's game. He won. Vaishali was able to win her game. Divya Deshmukh and Mrudul Dehankar in an all Nagpur battle. This was won by Divya. She had an extra piece and she managed to create a nice checkmate at the end. There was a FIDE trainer seminar where the participants were taught about how to make the best use of chess-based softwares. I was the one who gave the lecture. There was also FM Peter Long, and there we had Chief Arbiter Hamid. A lot to expect in the next round. See you soon with the highlights.